Unit number one, introduction to abnormal psychology. Introduction. Man is suffering today because of war, disease, corruption, crime, inner conflict, natural calamities, etc. Solutions of all kinds, economic, scientific, political, religious, etc. have been tried, but man has not been able to attain eternal peace and prosperity. The reason for all this is that man does not have mental purity, proper values, right attitudes, and divine qualities. Mental tension is the cause of most of the crimes in the world. Many diseases are also due to psychological imbalance, nervous strain, and hypertension. In order to feel relaxed, some people nowadays take tranquilizers, name of the drugs. They smoke marijuana or use LSD drugs. But these things have harmful effects on man's mental faculties, and they make him a slave of the urge to take them again and again. It has now been demonstrated that the best course to be free of mental tension is to practice yoga, meditation daily, even though for a short while. So yoga and meditation is very effective tool to control the stress, tension. Depression, maladjustment, bad company, love, starvation, etc. lead one to smoking, drinking, and drug addiction. These habits are a drain on money, cause disease, give wrong mental attitudes, and vitiate the atmosphere. We keep observing many individuals around us in the world whose thoughts, speech, or behavior differ from normal individuals. The field of abnormal psychology is wider. Abnormal psychology studies different types of behavior disorders. For example, a frustrated child by refusing or playing games begins to stuck its thumb. And a small child, when refusing playing games again and again, started the abnormal behavior like begin to stuck its thumb. A housewife clouded by constant anxiety becomes absorbed in cleaning house often and again, maybe 2 times, 3 times, 5 times. House cleaning, this is the sign of anxiety. A businessman getting news of loss in future has ulcer in his stomach due to more fear and criticism. A student having feeling of insecurity is lost in fantasy. A frustrated retired worker in the old age due to decreasing abilities try to suicide. These behavior disorders become problems for relatives and friends, as well as for the individual involved. The existence of deviant behavior make an urgent demand on society. Abnormal psychology is the special discipline that seeks to describe, to explain, and to discover ways to cure these disorders. Now, the definition of abnormal psychology. First definition given by Jack Roy Strange, intonated comma. Abnormal psychology is the branch of psychology that is concerned with the behavior disorders, their diagnosis, their classification, their treatment, and the theories that explain them. So here, abnormal psychology is a branch of psychology and concerned with the behavior disorder, their diagnosis, which type of disorder labeling, and their classification, and then their treatment and the theories also. Second definition given by J.C. Coleman, abnormal psychology is the field of psychology which specializes in the development and integration of psychological principles for the understanding of abnormal behavior. Here also, is a field of psychology and specialized in development, integration, psychological principle. So using the psychological principle, they treat the patients having mental disorders. Then third definition is given by Carson, Butcher and Mineka. This is the main definition you have to write in the examination. Abnormal psychology is the field of psychology concerned with the study, assessment, treatment and preventive of abnormal behavior. So through all this definition, there is a nature of abnormal psychology. First point, abnormal psychology is a branch of psychology. Second, abnormal psychology is a behavioral science. Third one, abnormal psychology studies different kinds of abnormal behavior and deviated personality. Fourth, abnormal psychology defines abnormal behavior and personality, shows its ties, clarify them, and the factors directly or indirectly working behind them are studied deeply. So here you can see that abnormal behavior and personality are defined by abnormal psychology, types, clarify, classification, and the factors behind them directly or indirectly working. Then fifth, abnormal psychology discovers useful tools, methods, and principles to solve the problems related to the society and for the treatment of disorders. Abnormal psychology is a theoretical and as well as practical science. Now, what do we mean by abnormal behavior? The word abnormal literally means away from normal. So, thus the key to a usable definition of abnormal rest on an adequate definition of normal. So first of all, you have to understand the normal. If we understood the normal, then we can understand abnormal easily. The word normal is derived from the Latin word norma, means a carpenter, square or ruler. This is the tool of carpenter that is called norma, and that means is normal. Here is the picture of carpenter's tools, ruler, that is called norma. This root meaning is still present in the usage of normal that relate to an accepted standard or norm, especially an ideal one. Another meaning of the word normal has grown up around the idea of statistical average, most often the mean or the median. As I explained before also, often we use the word normal in a sense that combines these two basic references, and sometimes we tend to confuse the two. Many bitter arguments have arisen because the two parties in a controversy were using the two different meanings without realizing it. So word is one and meaning is different. So there is confusion. Now according to average statistical meaning, the mean and median, here example is given that more are in number, they are called the normal, and less in number, they are called abnormal. So here the example is a doctor is in less number, therefore abnormal, and patients are in number, so they are called normal. So this is the confusion. So about the another example, a judge and advocate. So judge are in less number and advocates are in more number. So judge is abnormal and advocates are normal. Another example, are teacher and students. So teacher are less in number, therefore they are abnormal, and students are in number, so therefore they are normal. So here confusion created. So it is not accepted in the science universally. So this is the first point within the definition, meaning of normal, abnormal, and what do you mean by abnormal behavior? Now the point is characteristics of abnormal behavior. Next point is characteristics of abnormal behavior. Within that first point, antisocial behavior. Abnormal behavior is not compatible with social behavior. Abnormal behavior is when a person's behavior does not conform to social norms or rules. Often such individuals are found to have antisocial behavior. When anyone do not follow the rules regulation of the society, they are called abnormal behavior, antisocial behavior. Such individuals tend to be more selfish rather than cooperative with other people in the community, regardless of their good or bad. For example, the tendency to steal, to commit violence, to rape, to commit murder, etc. are kind of antisocial, in which social norms are violated. This type of behavior is therefore called antisocial behavior. Second point, mental imbalance. Individuals with abnormal behavior are mentally unbalanced. Instability is seen in their thoughts, behavior, etc. They think one thing at a time, immediately think of another, and behave upside down than previously thought. Thus, the normal person thinks while remaining mentally healthy and who can implement that idea. Abnormal individuals cannot do that. They are said to be abnormal because of a mismatch in their behavior and thinking. Third point, poor adjustment. Adjustment of individuals with abnormal behavior is found to be inadequate. Instead of trying to solve, they wallow in their sadness and thus experience more failure. In different social situations, their adjustment is not systematic. Such individuals with other individuals in society, instead of harmonizing with individuals, frequent and unnecessary conflict ensue. So that such a person becomes the object of contempt of relatives, friends, family, neighbors, everyone. Sometimes a person with abnormal behavior causes problems for himself or those around him due to lack of adjustments. So this type of abnormal person is not able to adjust with others in society, in different events, different programs of society. So that is called poor adjustment. Then fourth point, lack of insightful behavior. A person with abnormal behavior lacks intuition. Due to this lack, a person who behaves abnormally does not have knowledge of good, bad, right, wrong, moral, immoral, etc. They cannot understand and accept their responsibility. They also do not hesitate to engage in immoral behavior because of a lack of intuition. Such individuals do not care about social norms and restrictions, so they behave according to the idea that comes to their mind. You know, like a Mary Marji, main chahe ye karu, main chahe wo karu. So they never care about the rules, regulation, and their lack of insightful behavior. And therefore, they continue whatever come in the mind. Fifth point is organized personality. Individuals with abnormal behavior tend to have disordered personalities. They do not have proper coordination in cognitive, functional, and emotional matters. They suffer from constant struggle and depression. Their behavior does not show order or organization. Their personality becomes so fragmented that their behavior cannot be predicted. At what time, how they behave, we cannot predict. They become irrational, unbalanced, and inconsistent. Thus, dissociated personality is a characteristic of a person with abnormal behavior. Then six, a feeling of insecurity. Individuals who behave abnormally experience feelings of lack of protection and insecurity. These individuals cannot accept that they are a part of society. Moreover, a person with abnormal behavior is viewed with suspicion by others in the society. They are not involved in social occasions or events for the exchange of ideas. Gradually, their feelings of insecurity intensify, and after all, such individuals do not accept social participation. They always live in a fearful mood and suffer from feelings of insecurity. So their life becomes fearful because of others do not accept them because of the abnormal behavior. So they are not the part of society as they feel, and this feeling is called feeling of insecurity. Then seventh point, emotional immaturity. Individuals with normal personality can express their impulse in a healthy way, but individuals of abnormal personalities lack emotional maturity. Such individuals cannot control the expression of their emotions. They experience emotions like laughing, crying, behaving strangely, getting angry for no reason. Being immature in the expression of emotions make one feel emotional, like crying on a good occasion, like marriage, or laughing on a sad occasion, like death. So here's the difference. On marriage, you start crying, and on the death, start laughing. So no control of expression of emotion. Their behavior does not correspond to their age, gender, status, or place. Emotional immaturity leads to serious problems with emotion adjustment in their behavior. For example, a young child who insists on chocolate before going to school is not emotional immaturity. It is a normal behavior. But if the young adult insists on the bike before going to college, cry, skip meals, etc., such type of behavior shows emotional immaturity, because he is young person, adult person. It is not expected by the society to behave like this. So if he behaves like this, that is called abnormal behavior in the level of emotional immaturity. Then 8 point, tension and hypersensitivity. A person with abnormal behavior is very sensitive. He cannot express his emotion properly. They experience constant stress due to feeling of insecurity or lack of safety. They cannot concentrate on any kind of work. They are so sensitive that they become agitated in small things. Moreover, their behavior lacks relevance. Thus, a person with abnormal behavior experiences constant anxiety, stress, and sensitivity. Then 9th point, no feeling of remorse. A person with abnormal behavior lacks insight. As a result, they cannot decide for themselves what is good or bad. So the work he has done is bad, and he does not regret that he should not do it. Moreover, since there is no understanding that the work done by one is wrong, the issue of repentance does not arise. Because first necessary to accept that is doing wrong. Then it can be do anything treatment like that. But it is not accept. So on, they are constantly doing the wrong thing one after the other, again and again. They don't care about society, family, friends, neighbors. So they do antisocial act and do not repent. Then 10th, lack of social esteem and self-knowledge. Defects are found in the self-knowledge or self-esteem of a person who behave abnormally. They can't evaluate themselves. They are not aware of their strength limitations. So they don't understand why people disrespect themselves. They cannot behave well in social occasions. Hence, they are the victims of criticism. Such individuals themselves do not understand why they behave in certain ways. So those who themselves are not able to understand why they behave in this way, abnormal behavior. They don't know the reason. As a result, they become increasingly counter-adjusted. Then 11th, lack of social adaptability. Defects in social adaptability are found in individuals who behave abnormally. Thus, individuals cannot establish satisfactory social relationships with their family, relatives, friends, neighbors, etc. The house in which they live cannot adapt to the home and other members of the household. They also become socially counter-customized due to lack of development of self-image and emotional instability. So they do not understand their own value also. And therefore, this is lack of social adaptability in home also and outside also in the society. Then 12th, improper evaluation of self. The normal person can evaluate the self, including his strength or limitations, so they have an idea of whether or not they can do some work themselves. A person who behaves abnormally cannot properly evaluate the self. As discussed earlier, a person who behaves abnormally does not know or recognize his or her strength or limitations. He works believing that what he does is the best, and failure to do so will result in an inferiority complex. No being able to choose a goal that suits their strength, their natural powers become dull, due to which their behavior is becoming more and more abnormal. So here he is not able to choose the goal, right goal, objective goal, and therefore his skills become dull, natural powers become dull. He cannot understand his own strength, and therefore he become more and more abnormal. Now the summary: a person who behave abnormally become more and more abnormal due to the severity of his symptoms. However, not all of the above symptoms are present in a person at the same time. Even if some of the symptoms are severe, the person's behavior progresses abnormally. It should be noted here that socially acceptable behavior means normal behavior, and antisocial behavior means abnormal behavior. That is, whether a person's behavior is normal or abnormal is determined by the rules of society. Such as a young man and a young woman in America behaving rudely or flirting in public is not abnormal behavior. But in India, in the island of rural, husband and wife hold hands and cross the road is abnormal behavior, because it is not expected by the society. Thus, a person's behavior can be determined as normal or abnormal based on the rules of society or culture.